the space that we believe is empty is not really so empty. It's full of a living essence, of a living material that we're only beginning to understand. We may have experiences inside of our bodies that influence the world beyond our bodies through the conduit of what's in this space.
What is happening to our Earth, and what is being done to the people who live upon it? Global fascism and oppression of the human spirit on a scale never before seen is coming. It's being instigated by very few people who sit at the top and pull all the strings, and it's happening right now. I'm asking you all to just stop for the moment and look around you and seriously think about things here. What has happened to the human race? Are we actually still in charge here anymore? Do you seriously think that we need to strip mine and deforest and depopulate this planet at the rate we are doing to support our lifestyle? Just stop. Look around you for a while. Go outside and look around. But look beyond the glamour and the bright lights and beyond the class or race divisions. And what do you see? You see people. That's all they are. Just people. Just like you and just like me. All the perceived divisions that supposedly exist amongst us are an illusion. All the flash and pizzazz is just a facade. It's all just for show. Look behind it to the real world. Humankind has gone to sleep, and we are sleepwalking into our own enslavement. We have, for the most part, forgotten what true reality is. We have been collectively taught, as whole societies, to ignore everything around us and to focus our attentions on the collecting of as much paper as possible from either working for or profiting from another human being, and then to use this paper to buy as many baubles and trinkets as we can in order to gain more status in our society. As such, we have become totally dependent on this temporary reality, and we have been convinced by a box in the corner called television that body image and the collecting of more and more paper and trinkets at the expense of everybody else is actually the meaning of life. We are kept in a constant state of fear. Fear of terrorism. Fear of everything. And you need to explain the issues outlined in this film to everyone. Feel free to research any points I have mentioned, as I have done, and you will soon find out that it's all true. So stop supporting this system, because the system not only does not support you, it has been designed to enslave you, and the prison door is now swinging shut. You need to recognize that all there really is people, and you need to stand by each other. And if you see injustice towards another, especially if the injustice is being delivered by police or government, then you need to seriously understand that it is also being perpetrated against you. Stop profiting from each other. There is no need for the world to be economically based. It should be humanitarianly based. We are all people, and we are all one. It is time for humanity to realize that, and it is time for people in both government and police forces to not only allow people to realize it, but to also realize it themselves. And it's time for the good people in both governments and police forces to also act and to do what is right. The crimes of 9/11 were not only an attack upon America, they were in fact the start of a never-ending attack on humanity disguised as the so-called War on Terror. Because the war on terror is not just directed at the Muslim countries who are being bombed. The target is the whole world, and the very survival of the human species is at stake here. People need to wake up to this, and it's become very obvious that we have to do it ourselves because the media certainly isn't going to help. The real need here, though, is to understand the awakening that is growing within yourself, to allow these changes to occur within your own psyche, and to remain centered. Offer the information contained in this film to those who will listen, but don't waste time arguing with those who are not. Eventually, as more and more people do awaken, it will affect the rest of humanity as the collective consciousness grows, and eventually the sheeple will follow, simply because that's what sheeple do. But as more and more people awaken, it affects those around them simply by matter of course, eventually reaching the entire species. Therefore, it is not important to spend your time awakening others per se, and ultimately there is no battle that needs to be fought on any front. the only thing that is important, my friends, is that you yourself awaken and you stay centered in that wakefulness. A true awakening within your own self will help awaken those around you. The whole system that we live in teaches us, drills into us that we are powerless, we are weak. Everyone is out to get you. There's always danger at the doorstep. And so people are automatically on the defensive and always expect the worst. But it's a lie. We are wonderful. We are beautiful, every single one of us. We are extraordinary, and there is no reason why we cannot understand this. There is no reason why the average individual cannot be fully empowered. We are very powerful beings. We have just been fed lies all our lives through a corrupt education system that teaches a blatantly false history to the world and is fueled by corrupt politicians whose only allegiance lies with international banking interests. Thus, we have been conditioned to not see our own worth and to look in the wrong places for what we are searching for. But once a person realizes the truth of how our world is run and who runs it, the players and their workings become utterly transparent, and all we have to do to fix it is to awaken others to the reality of the situation and to stop going along with it. Do not accept any RFID tracking chips or smart cards from a criminal government. Do not accept your water being poisoned with fluoride. It's time to wake up.
This transmission is coming to you.